So, my fellow Toastmasters, love is in the air, and I think, just kidding. Valentine's Day is just around the corner. So, does everyone here have a date for Valentine's Day? Yeah. Why mix hands, please? I don't have a date on Valentine's Day. It's okay. It's okay being single. I enjoy watching Netflix and drinking my pineapple juice on Valentine's Day. So, did you know that Valentine's Day originated as a feast day for St. Valentine? But now, Valentine's Day is commercialized and celebrated as a holiday to spread the love, and thus our team Step Up to Love comes in. So, what can others say about our team, Step Up to Love? What do you think is the idea, Step Up to Love?
Love more.
Love more? Yes? Can we love more? Montes, any idea?
We have to give sacrifices for our family. And of course, also if we are single with partner, with boyfriend, we have to sacrifice for our love for our boyfriend.
Toastmaster,
right? I believe it's not necessarily romantically love by itself. I believe it's, we should develop an attitude of gratitude for us to feel the love that we are getting from this world, from people around us, from our friends, our loved ones. Mm-hmm. And that, I believe, is we do a step up with love. Love another level.
Like, upgrade. So, step up to love, or who gave this thing? Toastmaster Lit? What can you say?
It's me and Christine.
Ah, yes.
But the phrase step up came from Brian. So we just added step up to love because it's Valentine's Day.
Upgrade. Step up your game to love, right? And something like that. So, to start our night and step up our game, let us call on Toastmaster Gid Mabayad to lead the Anything Goes portion of our team.
Thank you to our Toastmaster for the evening, Jamie. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
I know we're all ready to step up to love.
Yes.
You know, since last week, I've been thinking, what is the lovely thing that we can do tonight where anything goes? And now I know. Everybody will have to sing a love song. Everybody, or at least those who are willing to sing. I think that's the most lovely thing we can do this evening. For anything goes, we will sing a love song. Maybe not all love songs have the word love in it, but we make sure that the lines of the song we will sing will have the word love in it. I think I should start it, okay? I should start it. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. No, not just for that one, but for everyone. So that's just an example. So everybody who would like to be the first one, or rather the second one, to sing a love song that would challenge us to step up
with the word love.
Yeah, with the word love in it. I know most love songs have love in
it. Yes. Endless love.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, that's a good idea. I can just sing on your seat, but if you want to stand up here and sing your song, that would be fantastic. So, my endless love. Who else like to sing? Pat is a crooner. Okay, come on, Pat.
No, wait, all the love songs that I know are ancient. Okay, so here's one. Love is a many splendor thing.
Amen to that. Thank you, Pat. Who else? Is the song to sing? I hope everybody has a line or two to sing. Everybody's in love anyway, right? So you must have a song in your heart. Maybe it's your anniversary song. Mm-hmm. I think Mark is ready to sing.
What about Mark?
You're still thinking on this topic.
Pick one.
Love. But if you really would like to sing a full song, that would be appreciated. And you have this place to stand and sing your song. Anyone? Kat, I think you have a song in your mind. Come on. Let's all sing tonight. And let love be in the air.
I'm still
thinking.
Love is high. Love is low. Love is wide. Love is deeper than the view of waves. Higher than this worldly place. Wider than the gap you.
I forgot the lyrics. Thank you for sharing that song with me. Okay. You think, right? Not yet.
I'm a speaker, not a singer.
Well, but if you think of a song later, you can just sing along. Okay, what about Cecil or Andrea?
You still thinking what?
Sandy, if you have a ready song. Anyone? Ladies, come on, sing your song.
I
this is
another
the thing.
Oh yeah, please. I want to know what love is.
You
want you to show me.
Ah, that's right. People got me, huh? I want to know what love is. Thank you for sharing your so endless love and I want to know what love is. You thought of it? No.
I'm speaking.
Yeah. I hope somebody could sing Evergreen. I really like that song. Yes, please.
Love, there's only you.
Hello.
Stand right. My first love.
Thank you for sharing.
Yes, my
come on. Other.
Love me, love me, say that you love me.
I want to
No. I'm a speaker and singer, not a dancer. But
thank you for sharing. Yes, yes.
One line only.
I want to share.
And variation.
Love is a many splendor thing.
Thank you.
Sandy first, okay.
Love is here, you say. It's always so surprising. When love appears over the horizon.
Thank you. Okay.
Cecil
has a
song,
Nadia. And what about
Nadia? Please. Love me for a reason.
Yeah.
Let me
see
love.
Yeah.
Love me for a reason.
Yes.
Right, if you have a song, please. If you don't want to sing it, you can recite it. The line to from the song that you love and not so that you know. How about Cecil? Have you thought of a song yet?
Yeah, so
pass.
How about love lines? Like, my heart is like a pepper. Many are trying to crush me.
Thank you, Ryan, for telling.
Okay. Are you sure we're done singing?
Yeah.
Well, thank you. Even the songs, the few lines that we heard tonight, speak to us about love. And before I end, let me give you this very important reminder. Please do not take for granted anybody that you love. Good evening, everyone.
Thank you, Toastmaster D, for the last line to leave anyone for granted. So I think everyone was refreshed through thinking of the love songs for Valentine's Day. Preparation. This is a preparation for Valentine's Day. So by the time that Valentine's Day arrive, yung utak nyo na meron na kayong love song pakaka-okay mag-isa joke. So, anything go session. To start our night, and hindi, for table topics, other than using our hearts since it's Valentine's Day, how about using our brains and wonder about these quotations that tugs our heartstrings? So, our table topic session is to be led by Toastmaster Sedi Cortez.
Good evening, fellow Toastmasters.
Good evening.
And happy Love Month.
Oh,
happy Love Month.
But don't forget Toastmasters Day, me, because it is okay if you have no date, just like me, because I have a date on February 14th. Woo! In office with work. But as what you have said, we should not only speak our hearts out, but we should also speak our brains out, because I will give 5 quotes that is related to our theme for the night. So for our first table topic, there is only one happiness in life: to love and to be loved. There is only one happiness in life: to love and to be loved. And I would like to give this quote to Toastmaster Jamie.
Good evening, fellow Toastmasters. There is only one happiness in life: to love and be loved. The Bible said that the greatest law is to love our neighbors as we love ourselves, right? And mostly, what the Bible say is, it's like the greatest law is to love and love and love. So I think when you give love, other than just, I mean, when you give love, what else do you feel? You also feel happiness, but also other than giving love, you also want to your love to be reciprocated, right? So I think being loved and to be loved is the greatest joy in life. Thank you, Toastmasters.
Thank you, Toastmaster Jamie. And for our second table topic, from David Wilkerson, love is not only something you feel, it is something you do. Again, Love is not only something you feel, it is something you do. Toastmaster Rye, can you take the challenge? Love is not only something you feel, it is something you do. I personally believe that for us to feel love in this world, we need to be thankful with all the blessings that we are receiving on a day-to-day basis. Because we can only feel love if we are thankful and we develop that attitude of gratitude for all the things that we are receiving in this world. Early this morning, ladies and gentlemen, my breakfast is fried alone, eggplant. And I am really thankful for that eggplant because it nourishes me for the whole day. And in fact, that is the only food I can remember I ate today. And because of that eggplant this morning, I'm able to speak in front of you. And for me, speaking in front of you is a blessing. And ladies and gentlemen, whatever blessings we are receiving, small or big blessings, we need to be thankful. Because after which, you can feel that blessing is a form of love from our Creator. And with that, thank you. I now return the table, the floor to our table topic.
Thank you. Thank you for teaching the concept of gratitude. And now for our third table topic. Love is like the wind. Love is like the wind. You can't see it, but you can feel it. Love is like the wind. You can see it, but you can feel it. Toastmaster Mark.
When was the last time you saw love? When was the last time you feel love? And you loved it within? Fellow Toastmasters, ladies and gentlemen, and netizens, somebody said that love is like the wind. You can see it, but you can feel it. I disagree. When you were in your mother's womb, you felt love. And when you come in the world as a human being, you were nourished. Your mother gave you the feeling of love. But it was not only invisible, it was also visible. And the visibility of this love can be done and can be measured through whatever we do. For example, in the concept of romantic love, when I had a girlfriend before, I gave her roses, I gave her something, I gave her chocolate, I gave her gifts. I have shown my love. However, I ensured that it was also visible because feeling is not only enough. Because we also need to be vocal and to be visible in showing love. Right? Love is like the wind. Yes, love is like the wind. we all love, we all feel love. It's February 14. And I'm after the February 14, because I'm after February 15, it's salary time. Because salary is more important than paid. Alright? So love is like a wind. You can see it, but you can feel it. But in my perspective, you can feel it and you can also see it. Because tabletop is master.
Thank you, Toastmaster Ryan. For our fourth table topic, to love oneself is the beginning of a lifelong romance. To love oneself is the beginning of a lifelong romance. And I will give this to Toastmaster Andrea.
Thank you for choosing me to speak on my second visit in your group. So, to love oneself is the beginning of a lifelong romance. So, we see a lot in social media today about, especially the young people, showing themselves and showing pictures of themselves. But you also know that sometimes you know people like that, but behind that, you know that they have a lot of insecurities about themselves. The little things like, you know, physical things in their body or their attitude. So I think that it is a great great form of love to accept and to love yourself despite these insecurities that we have of ourselves. So I think that once we get over that and we love ourselves, it is the beginning of loving ourselves throughout our lives. Thank you,
Toastmaster Andrea. And for our last table topic, this is the title of a song from Mariah Carey. Love takes time. Again, love takes time. And I will give this to our upcoming contestant on our Area 63 contest, Toastmaster Liam.
Do you believe that love takes time? That's very true, because true love waits. Love doesn't happen overnight. We have heard a quotation earlier that you can't see love, but you can feel it. But Mark disagreed with that, and he said that love is something you feel, and love is also something you see, because through action, love is manifested. And because love is not just something that we say, it's something really that we do, it's something that we feel, love takes time. You know, before you get acquainted with a child who is not really a part of your family, you have to see that child over and over again, because at first that child won't come to you, won't talk to you. The child would show that he dislikes you. But then after so many meetings, you would see that that child has come to become familiar with you. You become familiar with one another, and then that could be the beginning of a beautiful relationship, and that is the realization that love really takes time.
And because love takes time, we shouldn't be in a hurry. For those who are not yet in love here, or for those who do not have a boyfriend or a girlfriend yet, you are not yet into a relationship, I think that's one thing you have to bear in mind, that love takes time. You really have to wait, because love is not there right away. I don't believe in love at first sight. You really have to make it grow little by little before you come to the realization that it's true love indeed. So wait for the right time, because love takes time.
So our participants, thank you for speaking with your hearts out. And before I end this table topic session, I will give a line from William Shakespeare. It was written on the back of our... It was written at the back of our program. Love all, trust a few, do wrong to none. Thank you.
Good evening, fellow postmaster. While waiting for dinner, I want to introduce the word for the night. Word of the night. Word of the night, you can see it on the back, on the second page of the program. It is called, the word of the night is meddlesome. Meddlesome, not meddlesome. Meddlesome. Meddlesome means full of vigor and stamina, spirited, fearless. So, when used in a sentence, the meddlesome opening band's number got the audience all jazzed up. It's like the spirited, the full of vigor opening dance number got the audience all jazzed up. So I hope everyone used the word of the night. Since our dinner is not yet ready, let us proceed with the prepared speakers for tonight. For our first speaker, she will be delivering her icebreaker speech. And the purpose of this project is to introduce yourself to the audience and learn the basic structure of public speaking. The title of her speech is Dream, to be delivered by Toastmaster Vivian Lapitan. The time is 4 to 6 minutes. The title is Dream, Toastmaster Vivian Lapitan.
Don't be afraid of the huge gap between your dream and reality. My fellow Toastmasters, good evening. My name is Vivian Ramirez Liapitan. I was born in a beautiful month of December in 1972. I came from a family of farmers, and I'm proud to say that I was born poor. When I was young, I started to dream. I wanted a big house, a car, and beautiful dresses to wear. My parents was always telling me, when you grow up, you will be a teacher. And being the most obedient child, I embraced it as mine. And so whenever our teacher would ask, what's your ambition, Vivian? I would always say, Ma'am, I want to be a teacher someday. But when I finished high school, my parents told me that they could no longer send me to college. I felt like a bird being deprived of soaring high. That was the moment I finally realized how hard it was to be poor. Such an eye-opener. The reality is, it is not easy to be poor, and it will never be. Have you experienced it though?
Yes.
No special food to eat, no new uniforms nor shoes to wear. I didn't realize all those things until the moment of truth hit me. I would no longer achieve my dream. And so I asked myself, what would happen if I stuck here? I didn't want to stay in our barrio all my life, planting sweet potato and water spinach? No. From there, I started to think and dream big again. I did not sleep the whole night until I got hold of the answer. Yes, I needed to do something. I decided to leave our barrio to look for a job. Fortunately, I landed my first job. At 17, I was a cashier at a gas station and sometimes refilling gas. After that, I had jobs working from one place to another just to support my studies and to support my parents. You wouldn't believe that my daily wage of 50 pesos was able to make me as a breadwinner. Such a winner, isn't it? For several years, my life had been like that until I earned my computer degree. Maybe some of you are wondering, what happened to my dream of becoming a teacher? Well, during my stints, I discovered something wonderful about me. My passion. I found out that my interest was really on computers. Since I was a very techie person. The idea of seeing myself as a teacher was strongly influenced by my parents. It was a good career path to take as I found a stable job, got married at 32, and now being blessed with two lovely kids. And you know guys, to see my aging parents enjoying their lives, by living with me in a big and comfortable house, riding a brand new car, eating and wearing all they want are big achievements for me. I feel fulfilled and abundantly blessed. I never stop dreaming and achieving my dreams until now, especially in my present career. Yes, I understand. Change won't happen overnight, and such turns cannot be done in a snap of a finger. But I need to take a first step to make that change happen right here, right now. Thank you.
Thank you for delivering your ice cream. Thank you for delivering your first speech, Toastmaster Video Libya. So for our next speaker, the objective is to deliver. For our next speaker, the objective is to deliver a practice speech for the contest with the title, What Do You Want to Be When You Grow Up? To be delivered by Mark Wilson Edrada. The time is 5 to 7 minutes. What do you want to be when you grow up?
I remember when I was in kindergarten, my teacher asked me, Mark, what do you want to be when you grow up? And he answered, I want to be a lawyer someday. But here's the catch. I didn't know what a lawyer was. I was just instructed by my mama that whenever a teacher asked me as to what I wanted to be when I grew up, just answer, to be a lawyer. Contest chair, fellow Toastmasters, and everyone who is clueless on what you want to be when he grows up. My dream of becoming a lawyer has changed when I entered high school. As we all know, in life, change is constant. And even change of dreams is part of life. When I was in high school, I was mesmerized by the documentaries, investigative journalism, and newscasting. I even followed the primetime news, the morning shows, and even Chile Kami. Yes, I wanted to be a news anchor. But the person back then was different from what you are seeing right now. I was shy, timid, and with a little speech defect. How can you be a news anchor if I can't understand what you're saying? Too fast and too furious, said my friend, who happened to be my number one basher. I cannot understand what you're saying. I cannot understand what you are saying. That statement echoed to me for a long time. Then again, I changed my dream of becoming a news anchor to become an IT professional. Have you changed your dream? Either because you were clueless on what you wanted to be, or discouraged by somebody else's opinion? A foreign medical drama series known as Good Doctor said, do you know what's great about dreams? That you can have another dream. It's like dreaming every night in your sleep, that you can dream another dream. You're not throwing your dreams away, but just having a different dream. You can have another dream. You can dream another dream. Yes, I'm not a news anchor. I've never become a news anchor because I learned to leave the dream of becoming a news anchor to become an IT professional. But by becoming an IT professional who travels here and there, paved a way for me to leave the dreams I left behind. Yes, I am not a news anchor that you can watch on mainstream media. But I became a video blogger that you can watch on social media. Shyness, zero. Timidity, nah. Speech defect, crush it, baby. Sometimes we are discouraged, distracted, and disengaged to take the path we always want to be. Sometimes people say, don't do that, you can never succeed on that. Sometimes people say, I want you to be like this fantasy. And while your fantasy increases, your reality increases. So, eliminate all those fantasies and come up with your own reality. A reality where your dreams and its achievement meets. A reality that fuels the energy within. A reality that says, hey, I can reach for your star. Yet still keeping your feet on the ground. Did I tell you that I wanted to become a lawyer? I am not a lawyer by profession. But now, I know how to defend myself, my family, and my dreams. With that, I'm still speaking with my original meaning. You can have another dream. You can dream another dream. Dreams come in different forms, shapes, and timing. You may not have achieved your dreams on time, but surely, definitely, you will achieve your dreams in time and in different packaging. You still grow up. You still grow up. I still grow up. You may have achieved your lifelong dreams, but life finds a way for you to grow up and know what you want to be when you grow up. Fellow Toastmasters, ladies and gentlemen, it's now my time to ask. What do you want to be when you grow up?
Thank you, Pastor Mark, for that wonderful speech. So for our third speaker, the purpose is to present a speech on any topic, receive feedback, and apply the feedback to a second speech. The title of her speech is, What Kind of Spender Are You? What kind of spender are you, Toastmaster Cecil De La Cruz? 5 to 7 minutes.
Thank you. I have one slide, but we don't have a projector, so I just use my laptop. Maybe go back. It's okay. Later na lang. Later ko yan. Okay. I hope my shyness is zero. My nervousness is zero. I hope I'm like you.
Okay.
Para makatanap. Okay. What kind of spender are you? One day,
I saw my classmate in a restaurant. She looked so different. She wore an elegant dress, a Tory Burch shoes, a Louis Vuitton bag, and a Rolex. Boy, she looked so expensive. Ladies and gentlemen, my fellow Toastmasters and guests, good evening.
Good evening.
Most of you know that I'm a unit manager at Sun Life of Canada. I teach financial literacy, the importance of having protection, savings, and investment. I will take this opportunity to teach you how to be financially free. Maybe you can still learn something from me. To begin, you must know that there are three kinds of spenders. There are three kinds of spender. Spender number one, income less expense equals savings. After receiving her salary, Ida immediately pays her bills. Meralco, water, cable, internet. Then, she buys groceries and goes to the wet market. Whatever is left, she puts in her savings account. But then, her friend called. Bes, there's a piece of fare going to Palawan. Let's go! Piece of fare? Is that really 1 peso? Not really, because there are taxes, charges, but still a good catch. Such a steal, come on! Let's have fun! Okay. So Ida withdrew her savings. She bought a luggage, a cute swimsuit, and some clothes too. So now her savings is zero. Now let's go to our spender number two. Spender number two is Lorna. Expense less income equals debt. Lorna is drinking her cafe latte in Starbucks. She's been thinking on how she could pay her loan in her company. Then, she saw a big sign, sale. So she thought that maybe she could forget her problem if she'd do some window shopping. So while walking inside the dep store, a sales lady approached her. Ma'am, look at this beautiful red dress. It's on sale. 50% off, ma'am. Wow, that is so nice, but not in my budget. And our salary is until at the end of the month. It's okay, ma'am, you have a credit card, right? Yeah, you're right. Okay, I'll buy that. Oh, wait, ma'am. Look at this pair of red shoes and this very nice bag. This will complete your attire. You will look so fabulous, ma'am. Oh, yeah. This really looks good. Okay, I'll buy that. Here's my credit card. So now, Lorna, by being an impulsive shopper, just added 30,000 debit to her credit card, aside from the 50,000 that is already due and the loan she had with the company. So our spender number one is Ida. She spends money as she saves. Sorry, Ida saves after spending. Our spender number two is Lorna. So Lorna spends money more than what she earns. Okay, so can you guess who's our spender number three?
Faye.
Let's see. Spender number three. Income less savings equals expense. She's very happy she just received her salary. She's drinking her coffee in Dunkin' Donut. She's waiting for someone. Then her financial advisor sees her. Hi, Lorna, how are you? Oh, thank you, Ms. Cecil, for seeing me. I'm so excited to hear your presentation. Can we start now? Sure. Yes, our spender number three is still Lorna. The same person as our spender number two. Lorna is the same person in my introduction, my high school classmate whom I saw in the restaurant wearing those expensive things. But Lorna is now ready to change her spending habits. After learning that I'm a financial advisor, she immediately shared her financial problems with me. Yes, she's in huge debt. 8 credit card companies were harassing her every day, calling her every day. She can't sleep at night. She have no peace. She even entertained the thought of committing suicide, but considered her 3 small children. So she willingly shared, confided everything to me. We talked for 4 hours. We prayed, we cried, until we came up with a solution. She tore all her credit cards right there and then, and when she went home, she confided her problem with her husband. Her husband got angry, of course. Who wouldn't be anyway? But in the end, helped her get out of debt. Because that is love. They step up to love each other more.
Whoa!
That was 5 years ago. The whole family is now my loyal client. And I'm overwhelmed to say that Lorna is one of my financial advisors who eagerly shares our mission. She has learned her lesson and she doesn't want that to happen to anyone. She always says, do something today that your future self will thank you for. She has really changed and I'm so proud of her. So how about you? What kind of spender are you? Are you like Ida, who has a roller coaster way of savings? Or are you like the old Lorna, who spends money she hasn't even earned yet? Who buys things she doesn't need, to impress people she doesn't even like? I hope everyone is like the new Lorna, who saves first before spending, who thinks of her family's future, of her children's education, and of her retirement. Good evening.
Thank you, Toastmaster Cecil, for the very informative speech. Good thing I already have an insurance. And I already have a savings. So, for our last speaker, the purpose of this project is to clearly define how Toastmaster envisions mentoring with the title, The Seed. The Seed. To be delivered by Toastmaster Sebi. The time is 5 to 7 minutes. The Seed, Toastmaster Sebi.
During our elementary days, we were lectured by our teachers how a seed grows into a plant. Every seed needs water, amount of sunlight, and the right amount of temperature. And when planted in soil, the embryo gets a signal to start growing. And as the seed coat cracks open, forms roots. And the shoot with a stem of the plant with a few leaves will push its way towards the sunlight. And with the right amount of sunlight, temperature, and water, the young plant will continue to grow, and will give more bigger leaves and produce seeds on its own. Fellow Toastmasters and friends, do not get me wrong, because we will not go in to study about gardening, nor botany. I just realized that we are like seeds. We have no idea of how can we use our existence in this world until someone taught us how to. I worked as an administrative assistant for more than 2 years. And I thought this job speaks more of clerical works, but it didn't. My job requires critical thinking skills and decision making, and most of all, patience. Right after I was hired, I met my immediate superior named Miss Sally. She was the one who oriented me so I could have a clear understanding on my job. She always asked how I was going. She gave me instructions, but she always explained the purpose of it. And that was the moment I realized that I was in the good hands. I found a mentor. And as his mentee, what I really need to do is to put my trust on her, that she will help me improve as a person. I remembered on my first week on my job, when I encoded a wrong input on my billing report. And I felt nervous because I might upset her. But thank God, because I did not make her angry. She just advised me to be attentive and be careful on the next time. And she ended up by saying, it's part of your learning process. During lunch breaks, she had a share of her experiences, her humble beginnings, her hardships, and her successes. She even told me her story of how she became a store manager. And she told me that she was a bad boss before, because she was a kind of person who was really hot-tempered. I was shocked because she literally changed. Because right now, she was very calm and bubbly. And that is something that I was like about her. She was humble enough to admit her imperfections because she will change anyway. And as mentee, I always listened to her advice. She once said that if the time comes, you will become a leader. Be compassionate to your subordinates. It was the fact that I was mentored by her during her stay in the office. She taught me how to decide carefully. She taught me how to think critically. And it was just sad that she left the office last March 2018 because she wants to enjoy her senior citizen label. And I am thankful that I met her. As someone who has mentored, is a privilege for me, because she was a mixture of light, water, and temperature to a seed like me. She helped me grow until I pushed myself to the limits. And while I was very deficient of my knowledge, she advised me to share the same to others. Fellow Toastmasters and friends, let us always remember that we are all seeds who are longing for a brighter life inside the soil. But there are people who will serve as the water and the sunlight, who will help us grow and push ourselves to the limit. We will grow leaves as they shed more water and sunlight of experiences. We will continue to grow until we bear fruits, and time will come for the seeds on our own. Madam Toastmaster.
Did everyone enjoy listening to the prepared speakers?
Yes.
How about we take a 15-minute break since our dinner is served? So break time muna tayo, guys. The food is on the other table. You can grab a plate then eat here sa table since there are no space.